Hello dear students, very good morning. We are learning the chapter Metals and Non-Metals. In the previous class, we have discussing the chemical properties of metals and non-metals, right? In that chemical properties of metals, one of the property we have studied, that is what happens when metals react with the air, right? So now let us study the another property, what happens when metals react with water. What happens when metals react with water? So here, some metals react with the cold water and some metals react with the hot water, and some metals react does not react with hot water and cold water, but they'll react with the steam. Okay, and also some metals does not react with water at all. So there are 3 to 4 different types of reactivity, so of metals with the water. So first let us see what happens when metals react with the water. So when metals react with the water, first it will produce metal oxide, okay, and also produces a gas called as hydrogen gas. And so when this metal oxide is react with some more amount of water, it will produce metal hydroxide. So first step is metal react with the water, it will produce metal oxide, okay. Metallo ಇಲ್ಲಿರುವಂತ ಆಕ್ಸಿಜನ್ ಜೊತೆ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ, ಹೈಡ್ರೋಜನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ರಿಮೂವ್ಡ್ ಆಸ್ ಅ ಗ್ಯಾಸ್. ಸೊ ವೆನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ಸಮ್ ಮೋರ್ ಅಮೌಂಟ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಆಕ್ಸೈಡ್, ಸಾರಿ ಮೆಟಲ್ ಹೈಡ್ರೋಕ್ಸೈಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಟೇಕ್ ಒನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್. ಸೋಡಿಯಂ, ಯು ನೋ ದಟ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಮೆಟಲ್, ರೈಟ್, ಅಂಡ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈಲಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮೆಟಲ್. ಲೈಕ್ ಸೋಡಿಯಂ, ಪೊಟ್ಯಾಸಿಯಂ ಅಂಡ್ ಲಿಥಿಯಂ ಆರ್ ಹೈಲಿ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಮೆಟಲ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ದಟ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಇನ್ ದ ಪ್ರೀವಿಯಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್. ವೆನ್ sodium reacts with the water, so this sodium will react with the oxygen present in the water, it will become Na2O, it is sodium oxide. Okay, next, so the hydrogen gas will be removed. And you know that it is highly reactive, so it produces more amount of heat energy. Okay, so when sodium reacts with the water, it is an highly exothermic reaction, it produces more amount of heat. So when this metal oxide when it reacts with some more amount of water, okay, what happens? So this Na2O and H2O combines to form NaOH. Okay, it is a sodium hydroxide. So students, if you remember in the previous class, metallic oxides are called as basic oxides, right? So here you can see sodium hydroxide, it is a base and it produces heat. So the reaction of the sodium, potassium and lithium with the water is, it is highly violent and exothermic reaction. So that avoid hydrogen gas, whatever the hydrogen gas produced, so it can easily catch fire. So this is what happens when metals react with the water. So this the sodium, potassium and this lithium will react with the cold water only. Now let us see how the metals react, some metals react with the hot water. Next one, you know that some metals does not react with the cold water, but they'll react with the hot water. So best example is magnesium. Magnesium does not react with cold water. It reacts with the hot water to form magnesium hydroxide and it produces hydrogen gas. Okay, so it also start to float due to the bubbles in the hydrogen gas. Okay, bubbles in the hydrogen gas will sticking to its surface. So magnesium hot water gaagdaga float aagta irutte, yake antandre, so when the bubbles of hydrogen gas produce, it will stick to its surface, a surface ke sutkondirutte, that's why it will start to float. So magnesium, it does not react with the cold water, but it will react with the hot water to produce magnesium hydroxide and hydrogen gas. So in the same way, calcium reacts with cold water only. Okay, calcium will also when the reaction of calcium reacts with the water, it is less violent. It is not like when compared to sodium. The heat which is evolved, it is not sufficient for the hydrogen to catch fire. Illi calcium water jothe react adaga fire aguvanta chances enu irala, because it is not that violent as sodium did. Okay, calcium reacts with the water, it will produce calcium hydroxide and water. So here also the calcium will start float, because the bubbles of hydrogen gas form, it will stick to the surface of a metal. Okay, ee hydrogen gas enagutte andre calcium yen produce agirutte alva adakke stick agirutte. So adikoskara, since gases will float on the water, so calcium will also float. So this is calcium reacts with a cold water. Students, as I told in the beginning, some metals does not react with cold water as well as hot water, but they will react with the steam. Andre haavi irutala adr jothe react agutte with the steam to form metal oxide and hydrogen. So such metals are like aluminium, iron and zinc. These does not react with the cold water and hot water, but they react with the steam. So there is one activity here. This experiment we need so all these apparatus like Bunsen burner, test tubes, cork stand, delivery tube, conical flask, and also beaker and other stand like this. So here we have to collect the sample first, like aluminium, zinc, iron, so these metals. And we need a wool or like cotton, it must be soaked in the water. Okay, because you know that when the Bunsen burner is burning, the water present here, it will start to evaporate. So that evaporated water vapors will react with a metal sample. Okay, here suppose if we have kept aluminium here and the apparatus are arranged like this, when the Bunsen burner is burning here, the wool will, the water present in the wool will start to evaporate. So that evaporated steam, whatever it is, it will be reacting with this metal sample. This metal sample, it is becoming a metal oxide. Okay. And the remaining hydrogen gas, whatever it is produced, it will come through this delivery tube along with this. So in this delivery tube, and here we have a setup in the beaker we have kept water, and in the test tube we have inverted like this. So from the whatever the gas that is produced, it will produce the bubbles here. So it shows that hydrogen gas is produced here, and also the metal sample become a metal oxide. So this shows that, this experiment shows that some metals react with the steam, but they'll not react with the cold water or hot water. Here is the reactions. So here aluminium reacts with the water, it produces aluminium oxide Al2O3 and hydrogen gas. And here when iron reacts with the water, it will produce iron oxide or ferrous oxide, and hydrogen gas is produced. So this is the action of steam on metals. And this is about hot water, cold water and steam. There are some metals like lead, copper, silver and gold, they do not react with the water at all. Water jothe adu react madade illa. So that's why in the reactivity series, if you check, gold, copper, silver are present at the bottom of the series. So they do not react with the water at all. So this is about what happens when water metals react with the water. So students, I hope you have understood this. Thank you.